Hey, what's up guys? My name is The Cherno and welcome back to my C++ series. Today we're gonna take what we've learned about classes so far and have a go at actually writing a class from scratch. And we're not gonna take it too far today. We're not gonna write some massively complicated class. We're just gonna write a basic log class that should demonstrate some of the basic features we've learned so far. Over the next few episodes, we're going to keep working on this class and slowly introduce new concepts. So you'll get to see the process and the difference of kind of going from a basic version of a class to a more advanced version that does the same thing but could be considered better code. But first, this video is brought to you by Amazon Music Unlimited, which is a fantastic ad-free music streaming and download service with over 40 million songs which you can listen to anywhere, anytime. Programming without music is just not the same. I mean, every day at work, I've got my headphones in, I'm listening to music, I'm concentrating, and I'm writing that good code. I've got a link to a 30-day free trial of Amazon Music Unlimited in the description below, so go ahead and give that a shot. If you do sign up, it does help support the channel and this series, so thank you very much to those that do. All right, so let's talk about this log class that we're about to write. What is this log class? So this log class is going to be a way for us to manage our log messages. So in other words, messages or information that we want our program to print to the console. This is usually used for debugging purposes, and it can really help us out in our game or application if we want to kind of see what's going on and just print the status of things into our console. Because the console in an application is really like an information dump, which we can use to just print out what's going on. It's also something that is practically guaranteed to always work, right? If we had a graphical display of a console in our game or something, that might be a little bit different and it might not work all the time, because if there's something wrong with our graphics rendering system or something like that, we might not get those messages printing properly. However, a console is something that's basically built into the operating system, so we can pretty much guarantee that it will always work. I also really like the idea of using a log class as an example, because a logging system can be as simple or as complicated as you want it to be. It's amazing how complicated some log systems are. Like, I'm talking thousands of lines of code just to print stuff to the console, but it's just so, so important for debugging and for development that it is definitely worth spending time on that. And not only that, but logging systems can do things like print just to the console, print to the console in different colors, actually output log messages to a file or over a network. There's so much you can do that you can literally make a log class be 10 lines of code or 10,000 lines of code. It's just, there's so much, which is why it's a great kind of example to just build upon. All right, so our log class is gonna be fairly simple to begin with. It's going to basically provide the ability to write text to the console, and it's going to maintain some kind of log level, which is basically what level of log messages we actually want to send out to the console. So we'll have three levels to begin with. We'll have error, warning, and message or trace. So basically what we can do is we can set our log system's level to be, say, warning, for example, which means that only warnings and errors will be printed, but not trace messages. So this is really useful if you just don't want to see a bunch of information, you just want to see what goes wrong or what your warnings are. You can kind of clean up your console a little bit by filtering what actually gets sent and printed. All right, let's hop in and take a look at what that might look like. Okay, so the first step, of course, is going to be to create that log class. I'm just going to write class log. All right, there we go, done. Can I go now? So now we need to think about how our log class will actually work. And a really good way of creating a new class or designing an API is by its usage. So I'm actually going to go down into this main function and start typing in how I might use that log class. So first of all, of course, I'm going to want to instantiate it. I may want to specify some kind of log level as an actual parameter, but I'll skip that for now. I'm definitely going to want to set a log level. So I might do something like set level, and then maybe something like log level warning for warnings. So this means that only warnings or more important messages, so warnings or errors, will actually be printed, but not trace messages. And then I might want to log a warning. So I might do something like log.warn, and then I don't know, hello or something like that. So now I know what my log class should kind of look like, and I can literally just go back and start filling in the blanks now. So over here, I'll start with all the public functions that I need, which is going to be a set level function. For now, we're just going to use integers as our log levels to keep things simple. That's going to definitely do something. And then I've also got warn. So warn is going to take in a const char pointer, which is going to be our message. We're just going to use const char pointers as strings for now. I am actually going to make an episode about C++ strings, so I don't want to complicate things too much right now, so we're just using const char pointers. There's really no harm in doing that for our purposes. And there we go. So now we aren't getting any more errors anymore because these functions do exist. However, of course, log level warning does not. So let's start by declaring our log level. We're going to want some kind of private member variable which will maintain what level the log is actually set to. It's going to be an integer and I'm going to call it log level. Now note that I'm using this m underscore convention, which basically tells me that this is a class member variable that is private. That way, when I'm writing code inside functions and I end up referring to member variables such as this, I know which ones are actually part of the class scope and which ones are member variables and which ones are just local variables. Using conventions like this isn't required, of course, but it does really, really help for you to actually organize your code and keep it clean, especially when you're dealing with large code bases and complicated classes and stuff like that. It just helps so much. So I really recommend that you do follow a convention like this. So that's our set level function written. You can see that all it does is assign our member variable with the parameter. So if I call set level with 2, for example, it will assign the value 2 to our member variable over here. Let's take that back to log level warning and let's actually start creating these integers. So instead of just saying that 2 will be info or trace or something like that, 1 will be warning and 0 is error. Of course, that's makes our code a little bit hard to read. If I just write code like this, set level 1, well, what is level 1? It's like, I don't know. I'd have to basically memorize that, okay, 1 is warning, and we don't want to deal with that. If someone else reads this code, they're going to find it a little bit difficult to be like, what is 1? What does 1 mean? So we want to create some kind of variable which has the value 1, which represents what we actually want to represent, which in this case is log level warning. So I'm going to come up here and I'm actually going to make them public variables. Now you can see that I've kind of got public written twice here, and that's because I like to separate different parts of my class. So in other words, public methods might go in one section and then public variables might go in another section, and maybe public static variables might go in another section again. This is just something that's part of my style. You don't have to follow it, but it is a suggestion. These are going to be constants. So I'm going to write const int and then log level warning, which we'll set to 1. I'm also going to write a log level for error, which I'll set to 0. And then I'm going to write one more for log level trace, which I might call log level info, and I'll set that equal to 2. So we have three types of log messages. We've got errors, we've got warnings, and we've just got information messages. By default, I'm going to assign my log level to be set to log level info, meaning that everything should get printed. Now, finally, I can write my warn function. So I definitely want my warn function to print something out to the console. So I'm going to be using cout for now, and then just cout my message. However, another thing that I might want to do is actually print what kind of message it is. So in other words, if this is a warning, I might want to print warning out the front and then my message. If it was info, I'd print info at the front and then my message, etc. So I definitely want to print something like maybe warning followed by my message. All right, there we go. That looks pretty good. So let's copy and paste this function and create one version for error and then another version for info. So I'm going to call this info. I'm going to change this to say info. And I'm going to change this to say error. And of course, this will be my error function. All right, pretty cool. So we've got a way to set the log level. We've got error, warn, and info. However, of course, right now, all of these messages are going to get printed all the time because we have no way to say that, hey, if the log level is set to warning, don't print info messages. We can add that functionality via a simple if statement. So in other words, if the log level, the current log level, is actually greater than or equal to the level for this particular message, then go ahead, that's fine. So we know in this case that log level error is set equal to 0, which means that if log level is 0 or above, it will log this message. We'll copy and paste this same code into warn and info, and of course change this to say log level warning, and this to say log level info. So via this scenario here, of course, if we specify the level to be log level warning, which means we're setting the level to be 1, if we try and log an info, then this comparison is going to be 1 is greater than or equal to 2. However, of course, 1 is not greater than or equal to 2, so this message will not get printed since this if statement will evaluate to false. We've got one final error here because log level warning, of course, is undefined because log level warning is inside our log class. So to fix this, we're just going to set this to be log.logLevelWarning, and there we go. We've set the level to be warning. Let's go ahead and compile this code by hitting Ctrl F7, making sure that everything works, and I'm going to hit F5 to run my code. All right, check this out. We've got our warning printing. It says that it's a warning, and of course we have hello. So let's try and print an info message. I'm going to print info, hello as well, and I'm also going to print error while I'm at it as well. So I've got three different log messages being printed here, or rather the same log messages, but at different log levels. And you can see here that only the warning and the error gets printed, info does not, because of course our level is set to warning. If we never set a log level, Then of course it should be using info as default, which means that if I run this, all three of these should get printed, and you can see that they do. And finally, let's go ahead and set that log level to be error. Log.logLevelError. We'll hit F5, and you can see here that only our error gets printed. All right, pretty cool. So we've accomplished all of our goals. We've created a very, very basic log class. Now I just wanna say that this is absolutely not how I would write a log class. Absolutely not. This is fairly terrible code for a few reasons, but it is very, very simple and it works logically how a person might think about writing this class. Not really how a programmer with a lot of experience would write this, of course, and I'm sure there are a lot of you watching this video being like, what code even is this? This is not a representation of great code, but it is simple code, and it is something that if you're just starting out, hopefully you will understand all of this. It also gives me a great excuse to show you guys how I might improve this class using a few different concepts and why this is bad. So over the next few episodes, we're going to spend some time learning more about C++ classes and learning more about how we can improve this and make this what I would call professional or production level code. But anyway, thanks for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please hit that like button. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram to keep up to date with what I'm doing. And if you really like this series and want to see more episodes like this, you can support me by going to patreon.com/thecherno. You'll get access to drafts of new videos as well as a discussion board where we can talk about what actually goes into these episodes. And you can have a say in deciding what gets cut and what stays. Another way to support this channel and these videos, which is completely free for you, is by getting Amazon Music Unlimited, of course, link is in the description below. It's a really great music streaming service and you can give it a go for free for 30 days. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.